talkingtoweekdaychurch.com. You know, Moses had to grow up foreign. That's what it was going to be. Oh, he didn't move very far. He just moved to the other side of the tracks. But he was a foreigner. There was no other way to explain it. He came from a foreign people who were hated, who were called those dirty shepherds. And the people didn't like it. They had a different culture, a different God, a whole different way of doing everything. They were just very foreign. And Moses grew up amongst that. Always knew who he was. He was a Hebrew. It was very clear. I mean, he could look at himself in the mirror any time and say, well, that's who I am. People, I'm sure, regularly reminded him of it. You know, I don't imagine everybody would have been able to, being a princess's son. I'm sure he was afforded a lot of space. But still, doesn't matter who you are, how rich, how powerful, how important, people aren't always nice. It's difficult to grow up foreign, to be different. That's what we're going to be talking about today. Heavenly Father, may we know how to be in situations where we're different, where it's difficult. May we look at how Jesus grew up foreign and how he lived. And may we do our best to live accordingly. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Our opening song is What If I Stumble? What If I Fall? It's by DC Talk. And it's a song talking about, people are watching me. I'm different. I am foreign. I'm not of this world anymore. My citizenship's in heaven. And if they're watching me, what if I stumble? What if I fall down? And what if things go bad for me? What if I don't live up to all I'm supposed to be? What do I do? This song's going to be a great encouragement to you, I believe. I'll see you again.
This one for the people. Is this one for the Lord? Or do I simply serenade for things I must afford? You can jumble them together. My conflict still remains. Holiness is calling in the midst of courting fame.
'Cause I see the trust in their eyes.
Though the sky is falling,
they need your love.
Compromise is calling.
What if I stumble? What if I fall? What if I lose my step and I make fools of us all? Will the love continue when my walk becomes a crawl? What if I stumble? And what if I
Scripture passage is Exodus chapter 2, verses 10 and 11. When the child grew up, she brought him to Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. She named him Moses because she said, "I drew him out of the water." One day when Moses had grown up, he went out to his people and looked on their burdens, and he saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew, one of his people. Isn't it funny? Now, Moses isn't a kid by now. We're not seeing Moses as a child. We're not even seeing Moses as a young guy. All that time, from once his mother had weaned him, and he went into the princess's house, we don't know what happens in his life. You say, well, how long has it been? He's 40. That's how old he is. He's 40 now. And he's come to what maybe we'd call today a midlife crisis of, who am I really? You know, I grew up as this Hebrew among Egyptians. But am I an Egyptian? That's who raised me. That's who I spent all my time hanging out with. These are the people I know better. I'm a prince. I'm an Egyptian prince. Or am I a Hebrew? Am I still just one of those dirty slaves? I don't know what brought him to this moment to want to step out and see what was happening amongst his own people, and to see how they were getting beat. I don't know what drove him to this. Different movies have made it happen 100 different ways. Different stories, probably 1,000 different ways, have shown that something led him to want to relate back to his own birth people instead of those who adopted him. Maybe it was God's moving in his life. I think clearly it was. How he did that, though, I don't know. God knew all along that he'd set Moses apart for something special. You know, it's difficult, though, growing up different. We just passed the Christmas season. We're just starting our new year. And Jesus is the ultimate example of growing up a foreigner. Nobody has ever come so far to be born. Nobody has ever left heaven to be born on earth. Only Jesus. Only Jesus traveled that far and came to a culture so radically different. We may think it's very different being a Hebrew or an Egyptian, but we're all people. How different would it be to leave heaven and become one of us and to grow up down here? And our song earlier said, what if I stumble? What if I fall? I don't know if Jesus ever worried about that. In fact, the Bible says, do not worry. So I imagine he never worried about anything. What an incredible way to think somebody lived their life. But history would be different if he'd ever stumbled or fell. You know, as Christians, it says that this world's not our home. There's that great song that says, this world's not my home, I'm just a passing through. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? You know, it says that our citizenship is in heaven, the Bible says. So see, we're foreigners living down here. We're living here and growing up here and spending our time here as foreigners, and it's very obvious. And as we see our people getting beaten and abused and hurt all around the world today, becoming martyrs for Jesus Christ, as they have for eons now, what do we do? We're going to see in the next few days how Moses responds and some of the things he does wrong. We'll see later some of the things he does right. But it can be very difficult living as a foreigner. But let me tell you this. The biggest and most important thing for you to remember is that you are a foreigner. Don't ever think that this world's your home. Don't get caught up thinking you've got to have everything right here and right now. Jesus said, lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven. That's your home. He says that I go to prepare a place for you so that where I am, there you may be also. Jesus is already trying to tell you, if you have accepted him as your Lord and Savior, heaven is your home, not right down here. This is just a staging ground, just to get you ready. This is your trial run for the real life that's coming after. And it's not going to last for 60, 70, 80 years. It's going to last forever. Eternity is a very long time. Use right now to prepare yourself, to be an example to others for where your true citizenship lies. Heavenly Father, we thank you very much that we represent not Canada, not America, not Holland or anywhere else. God, we represent heaven. We're your children. And God, I pray that we will act as citizens of heaven. following our King, our Lord and Master. It's in His name, Jesus, that we pray. Amen. Our closing song is Tea and Sympathy by Jars of Clay. And I think you're really going to like it. It was a song from back when I was in high school. It was a really cool song at the time, and I hope you still like it today. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and I'll see you again tomorrow.
Fare thee well. Trading all our words for tea and sympathy. I wonder why we try for things could never be. Play our hearts lament like an unrehearsed symphony. Not intend to leave this castle full of empty rooms. Love the captive in the tower never rescued. And all our victory songs seem to be fading out of tune. 'Cause it's not the way it has to be. Don't trade our love for tea and sympathy, no. It's not the way it has to be. You begin all your words fall to the floor and break like china cups. And the waitress grabs a broom and tries to sweep them up. I reach for my tea. Teaspoon.